Hello to all of you who are just coming in from the waiting room. I'm Rick Stevens, and this is the Parkinson Network of Mount Diablo, and this is a Lunch and Learn series. Today, it's the joy of singing, or call it what you will. All right, so let me give you a very brief rules of the road. The rules of the road are typically people come in. Like Yvonne, you'd want to mute yourself. People come in and they are muted so that we can hear Judy or the main speaker. We do have a chance. Obviously, you're all going to want to unmute yourself when we get to the singing portion. So you'll be asked to unmute. So if you'd like, why don't we try that now, just to get ahead of the curve here. Everyone, why don't you unmute yourself? You don't have to have the camera on, that's fine. But if you'd like to try the singing, unmute yourself. If you have questions, you know, our group is contemporaneous and spontaneous. Feel free to ask a question at any given point, you know, and to sing at every point. Yeah, I'm just letting, you know, I like to give a couple of minutes for people to get on in.
Happy holidays, everyone.
This is Judy here. Okay, so.
I'm trying to see everyone here and scroll down.
Yeah, go to gallery view.
Got it.
Now, you know, some people, you're not required to turn your camera on or anything. You can simply be a participant and listen. That's just fine. All right, so what we do is we record these. So if you want to go back and listen to it again or watch it again, it'll be up on our website within 48 hours. We will send you the link, or if you subscribe to our YouTube channel, you'll get an automatic notification. But if you're on a mailing list, you'll get a notification automatically as well. All right, this is Judi Spencer from the World Parkinson Choir, and I'm going to let her introduce herself. Right now, I'm going to spotlight her so that you can see her and her alone.
Wow.
Right now. Okay, you're spotlighted, Judi. So why don't you open up and explain to us what we're going to do today?
I will, for sure. Thank you so much, Rick, and thank you for inviting me to be here with you today. And if you see my little elf ears, believe in your elf. I just thought this was the perfect little hat to wear today for our sing-along, because we have to believe in ourselves, because often we make a joyful noise versus, you know, I'm sure all of you or some of you could say, at one time in your life, a teacher or someone said, maybe you just better go play football or paint a picture and not sing in the choir. Has that happened to anyone? I know. It's amazing. I tell you, we all can sing. And for Parkinson's, those that are touched by Parkinson's, the best way to keep our voices spry and strong is through singing and singing together. And though we haven't been able to do this now for almost 2 years because of COVID, we are able to sing together via Zoom, which I think is a wonderful gift that has been given to us so that we can be together. And it looks like, and I understand you've been having this every week or every month, Rick, where you get together?
Every month for the Lunch and Learns.
Every month on the Lunch and Learn, which is fabulous. So as we get started, I'm going to have a little PowerPoint up, so which is just going to have words and a few pictures and things as we go along. But I thought you might like to know a little bit about myself, Judi Spencer, and how I became involved with the Parkinson's community, and especially through music. I am a daughter of a person with Parkinson's. My father Ken Pritchard was diagnosed with Parkinson's in 1995. And I was with him when he was diagnosed. And he lived in beautiful British Columbia. I am Canadian. And so I spent a lot of time with Dad. And Dad loved music. He played piano like Liberace and Roger Williams. He was beautiful. He loved to play the harmonica. He had a gorgeous voice. His voice was very similar to Perry Como. So we had a lot of music in our home and grew up with music. So as Dad's Parkinson's progressed, we did a lot of singing at the piano. And when he couldn't play piano anymore, I played for him and we would keep singing. And I could see the progress and the benefits of singing for Dad. And so he passed away. He passed away in 2002. So Dad's been gone for a while. But I promised Dad that I would always stay involved with the Parkinson's community. And it is the best promise that I've ever made. I tear up every time I talk about it because I've been involved now with the Parkinson's community, well, since Dad. And now it's global. And I went back to university to get a doctorate level degree so I could really understand the brain, what goes on with the brain and Parkinson's, and how music is a healing medicine for Parkinson's. So that's what we're going to be singing today, which is lovely. But let me share my screen right now. It's going to take me a minute to get here probably. Can everyone see my screen as it pops up?
Yes.
Good. The Joy of Singing. That's the best title that I could come up with because it is a joy to sing, even if we make a joyful noise versus a joyful singing voice. And this is a picture of my dad. I see he was very musical, but he loved the outdoors as well. And his favorite thing to do was to fish. So I believe this picture looks like it was taken probably near Calgary, where I grew up, it looks, by the trees that I'm looking at right there. So put your hands up if you enjoy singing. Okay, I'm seeing a few that hands that are still down. Those that hands are still down, are you going to sing with us today? Yippee! And I wanted to say, why do we sing? And the first thing that comes to mind is so we can meet new people. It's a great way to meet new people. And these are true facts that I have found online. When you get together, nothing is better than singing together with others and to meet others and to grow friendships. It's also very, very good and healthy for our heart. And it makes us happy. It doesn't matter where we go, music is always playing at the gas station, in the grocery stores, whatever store you go into, it's going on. And probably as you're going down the road, often you have music on as it's playing. It just really does something to us and makes us feel good. And it helps us look good. I love this one because as we sing, it's better than having it's a facial really, and stretches our muscles out and keeps everything looking good on our faces and keeps the twinkle in our eye at the same time. It's very healthy. It gives us confidence. It helps us relax. Often I find myself putting on music at the end of the day at a very calming tempo that relaxes me. And this is the best one. It is true that singing can help stop snoring. So keep that in mind. I love that. And singing with Parkinson's. You've probably heard the fact that 90% of people with Parkinson's experience changes in your voice. With that, most commonly, the voice becomes quieter or softer. And sometimes it can be breathy or hoarse. Also, the speed of your voice can change. Some people end up speaking very slowly, and some people talk really, really, really fast because you have to get everything out, and it changes the voice. It is very true that the symptoms are due to brain changes that make it difficult to follow internal cues. When you think of that, as we know, when we lose 80% of the dopamine in our brain is when the symptoms of Parkinson's show up, and one happens to be with our voice. So in order to get those neurons shooting and working and keeping everything going, it's great to sing, because we want to keep this going and we want to keep the smile on our face at the same time. And another thing that I talk a lot about, I'm sorry, I'm moving my chair here, is posture. With Parkinson's, our shoulders hunch over and our backs hunch over, and it immediately affects our voice because we're crunching everything down here in our chest and in our throat, and it's very hard to speak. So I love this visual here, because you would think the visual on the far right would be the way that we want to sit, but it's actually too strong. The one in the middle is the proper stance because you're relaxed. And with my tremolos, and I've got a few with us here today, which I love seeing, what we do in class is I just say, relax your body, and you can do this with me, and just let your body fall over and your shoulders fall over, and then start pulling your body up from the bottom of your spine, one vertebrae at a time, all the way up, and then roll your shoulders back and sit in a chair that your feet are comfortable and flat on the ground, so you have a really strong, firm, supported way of sitting. And the chest is open. My head is kind of, think of a bobblehead, move it back and forth, up and down. You don't want your neck sticking too far forward or too far back. You want it just relaxed. You want your arms relaxed and your shoulders down and back. Doesn't matter with Parkinson's or without Parkinson's, as we age and our numbers seem to be getting higher, our shoulders seem to move forward. So I always say, one exercise I do not do is rolling shoulders forward. I just roll them back. So think about that during the day. If you find yourself starting to fall over, pull yourself back up again and roll your shoulders back. Breath is very important as well with speaking, as well as with singing. But with speaking, we want it open. And I love the picture of our lungs on this particular slide. So I would like you to breathe deeply from your lower lungs down here. You can put your hands on your lower part of your lungs and imagine a rubber band or a rubber ring around your waist, and you have to push it out. So breathe in deeply through your nose and push that band out, and you'll feel all that wonderful air coming into your lungs and into your body. And then let it out through your nose or through your mouth and just let your body relax, okay? And avoid, you don't want this. We don't want to raise our shoulders. If you can see me on screen, don't raise your shoulders, but keep them relaxed and back. Take a deep breath in and pretend you've got that rubber band around you, and then let it out and relax. In, breathe in. And let it relax. Excellent. We are actually going to breathe with a song in the background. We're not going to sing. We're not going to use our voices at all to start with. We are just going to sit and breathe. And first we will breathe pretending we have that rubber band around our waist and we're pushing it out. And then you're going to see me raise my arms up and out into the victory V and open my chest out and then come back down. So just follow me. Make sure you can see me on screen. Okay, so let me start. Give me a second here. I'm going to have to, I think it's this one. It is coming. Here we go. Okay. You just need to follow me. So breathe in. Out. In. Out. Relax those shoulders. In. Out. Now place your hands on your lap and just breathe normally. But concentrate on your breath. How does it feel? Is it nice and deep? Or is it shallow? Breathe in deep. Might want to close your eyes so you can feel it. Put a smile on your face. Now open your eyes and we're going to raise our arms. Here we go. Breathe in. Smile and let it out. Let it out through your mouth and just let it go. In. Out. Can you see the smile and the twinkle in my eyes? I want to see that on you too. Breathe in. Out. In. Out. Now twist one way, breathe in. Twist the other way. That's excellent. So let me stop this. Beautiful. That was beautiful. So you should already feel that, oh my gosh, I feel, you might even feel a little lightheaded because you haven't been breathing deep. Need to do that throughout the day, thinking about how our breath is, because the breath of the body helps us with balance, helps us with our voices as well, and helps us think clearly as well. So get that deep breathing going. Another exercise that I love to do are tongue twisters. So in front of us, we have three tongue twisters in front of us. One is with an S for seven Santas, which we'll start with, just the first one.
It sounds, you have to advance your slide.
It should be up there. It should be right there. Is it on?
Seven Santas sang silly songs. Yes.
That's it, Rick. That is what we are going to say. Seven Santas sang silly songs. And I am going to mute everyone out except me, or it's going to be a mumble jumble. Okay. And hopefully you can still hear me. Whoops, go back. Get rid of that. And what I like to do is cross hands over and keep a steady beat. So it will sound like this. Seven Santas sang silly songs. And really exaggerate the S's. Okay, take a deep breath. And here we go. Seven Santas sang silly songs. Okay, hold on a second. Let me make sure everybody is muted. Should be muted all. Okay. Oh, I keep clicking and it keeps going forward. Let's do it again. Cross your hands over the other way this time. Take a deep breath. Seven Santas sang silly songs. And if you look at my face, it's actually putting a smile on my face as we go along. The next one is, how many deer would a reindeer rain if a reindeer could reindeer? So it's still working the smile on our faces through the R. I will slow it down. Join when you can. How many deer would a reindeer rain if a reindeer could rain deer? Okay, one more time. How many deer would a reindeer rain if a reindeer could rain deer? Excellent. Now let's do the last one, which is a hard K. Sounds like this. Chris Kringle chose to climb the chimney at Christmas. So you have the CH and the hard K. Let me say it one more time. Chris Kringle chose to climb the chimney at Christmas. And if you see my lips, now they're coming out, almost into the kissing position. Chris, never know what I'm gonna say. Chris Kringle chose to climb the chimney at Christmas. So let's put our pointers up on our face so we can feel it. And here we go. Chris Kringle chose to climb the chimney at Christmas. One more time. Chris Kringle chose to climb the chimney at Christmas. One more time. Chris Kringle chose to climb the chimney at Christmas. You can Google tongue twisters. Tongue twisters for the month of the year. You never know what's going to come up, but they are wonderful, wonderful vocal exercises. So we've done the breath. We've done the tongue twister. And we're just going to do a couple voice exercises that maybe you can remember at home. And I'm going to do them a little out of order. The one is the yawn. Everybody take a big yawn. It just opens everything up in our throat and our voice. Gets everything open. Another really good one is blowing bubbles, to pretend that you are underwater and blowing bubbles. And this can be hard. But I love, again, to use my pointer fingers and put them on the side of my cheeks. Take a deep breath and imagine I'm jumping into the pool and then just. Oh my heavens, that gets those muscles working in those lips. Do it one more time. Wonderful. And the other exercise that I love to do is just, we like to sing numbers, and if you can count to nine, you're safe. Okay? And we can sing it in various languages, but today we are going to sing it in English. It sounds like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And it comes back down. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I want you to try it with me, and then I'm going to ask you to unmute after we do it together. Let's not unmute yet, but try it with me. 1, 2, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Take a breath. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we're gonna climb up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Take a breath. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. We're gonna go climb up. Now accent the odd numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Breathe. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Excellent. Everyone unmute for me if you can, please. Lovely, lovely, lovely. We are going to sing this together, and you're going to see what happens. So most of the time, Rick, when we're going to be singing the carols, I will mute everyone out. Otherwise, it's a big mumbled mess. But it's wonderful to have a mumbled mess once in a while. And yes, so we're going to try it on this exercise, okay? And let's start with this, and we will play, we won't accent anything, but let's, you'll try and stay with me, and it's going to sound really funny. Okay, here we go. Take a breath and we'll end up together. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Isn't that beautiful? Isn't that the most beautiful noise you've ever heard? Yeah. We're going to do one more, and we're going to accent the odd numbers. It's harder to accent the even numbers because it's off the beat. So we're going to accent the odd numbers, and I want you to sing as loud as you can and as exaggerated as you can. If any of you have taken any speech therapy, everything is exaggerated to get all our muscles moving in our face. Okay, are we ready? Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, 75, 76, 77, 78, 79, 80, 81, 82, 83, 84, 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, 91, 92, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 100, 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, 110, 111, 112, 113, 114, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, That was beautiful, everyone. I loved it. So today I thought it might be fun just to sing a few holiday songs. And the first one that I have chosen is Deck the Halls. Deck the Halls because we love to deck the halls. Deck the Halls also because of the lyrics. So we have the fa, la, 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 la. And you can see my jaw, la, 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 exaggerating again, down. We need to use it. My goal today for each one of you at the end of this hour is your face is going to be tired. And your voice is going to be tired. And that's good. Because we're using the muscles on our faces within our voices as well. Mm-hmm. And energy. So you might take an afternoon nap that you never do before because you're a little bit exhausted. And I'll go, hee-hoo! Fa-la-la-la-la, fa-la-la-la-la. Everyone say that with me. Fa-la-la-la-la.
Fa-la-la-la-la.
That is fabulous. Okay, so if you notice, I have my piano beside me, which is a beautiful, I think it's about a 5-6 grand piano that my father gave me on my 16th birthday just a few years ago. And it has been with me everywhere I've traveled since. I love this piano. It brings many wonderful memories of my father. And I will add one more story to this. When my husband asked me to marry him, this piano needed some work. So he said to me, would you like to have a nice engagement ring and wedding ring, or would you like your piano refinished? And guess what I said? My piano refinished. This is just beautiful. And turns out I have trouble with metal anyway, so I have a little kind of elastic band wedding ring. I love that story. Okay, so we are going to sing Deck the Halls. There's three verses, and I have to pause slightly at the end of each verse because I have to press the button in order to get to the next verse. Okay, so I'm going to have to mute everyone out again because I want everyone to be singing, and I know you're singing with me, and I'll try and keep the tempo down a little bit so we can really exaggerate the fa, la, 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 la. So intro, let's see, we should go. Deep breath, here we go.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa, la, 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 la. 'Tis the season to be jolly, la, la. Don we now our gay apparel, fa la 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 la. Troll the ancient yuletide carol, fa la 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 la.
to the next verse, and I'm going to sing it an octave lower, maybe. See the blazing Yule before us, fa la 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 la, la 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 la. Strike the harp and join the chorus, fa la 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 la, la 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 la. Follow me in merry measure, fa la 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 la. While I tell a Yuletide treasure, fa la 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 la. Okay, man, I expect you to be singing this one now and fast. Here we go. Fast away the old year passes, fa la 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 la. Hail the new ye lads and lasses, fa la 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 la. Sing we joyous all together, fa la 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 la. Heedless of the wind and weather, fa la 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 la. You guys sounded so good. I loved it. Okay, I'm not going to unmute you yet, but I'm going to ask, does anyone know this beautiful song, Happy Hanukkah, My Friend? Absolutely gorgeous song. And I'm just going to play a little bit of it. Even Hanukkah is over. It ended last Sunday. But this is a song that we all can sing. I love the words because it's talking about friendship and letting our candles glow. It's absolutely beautiful. And let me just play a little bit of it. Like this. Spin the tree. No, I'm gonna go low. Spin. No, I'll go that high. Sorry. Spin the dreidel. No, I'm gonna go low. Spin the dreidel. Light the lights. Everyone stay home tonight. The story is told. The young and the old together. Twilight's in the setting sun. Light the candles one by one. Remember the past, traditions that last forever. Isn't that gorgeous? It's such a beautiful song. And I thought, well, I'm going to show you where you can find this song on the internet. So down here at the bottom is my website. It's very simple. You can just type in judyspencer.com. The hardest part is to make sure that you spell Judy with an I and not a Y. So I'm going to click on it right now, and up comes the front page of my website with my picture on it. And on the side here, if it doesn't show up already, it shows all of my pages. And this one here near the bottom, Holiday Sing-Along, if I click on it, there's a picture of the tremolo singers. A couple years ago, we were at the Booth Gardner Parkinson Center in Seattle singing for Christmas. And below it are a whole bunch of holiday songs that you can click on and sing at any time. And there's a bonus down at the bottom, if it'll show me here. I've got you guys in the way. Let me push this over here. A 3-hour bonus of instrumental Christmas music if you just want to click on it and play, which is absolutely beautiful. But we're going to go to number 3, Happy Hanukkah, My Friend. And it is a version of the song. It's a little fast, but it's beautiful. And it has the words up on it. So you can either listen or try and sing along with it, because I believe you will really enjoy it. Here we go.
Through Hanukkah celebrations, we eat latkes, we spin the dreidel, and and we light the 8 candles of the menorah to remind us of the miraculous event that the Jews witnessed in Jerusalem so very long ago.
Spin the dreidel, light the lights. Everyone stay home tonight. The story is told, the young and the old together. As twilight greets the setting sun,
as twilight greets the setting sun,
light the candles one by one,
light the candles one by one.
Remember the past, traditions that last forever. Come, let's share the joy.
Isn't that a gorgeous song? It's definitely worth sharing with one another. We're a family that has Christian as well as Jewish, and I came across that, and I just love, love, love that song. Okay, now we're going to sing a Christmas melody, or a medley, which actually starts with Deck the Halls. So we sing Deck the Halls, followed by Up on a Housetop, followed by Dashing Through the Snow, Jingle Bells. So I'm going to lead you on this, and we're going to sing this a cappella. You're actually going to hear my voice. And maybe at the end, we might sing a little bit more so we can sing jingle part of Jingle Bells together in a mumbled Jingle Bell mess. But let's start this off, and I thought, no, this way I can see how everyone's using their fa-la-la-la-la and getting everything working here. So I think we're gonna sing it a little bit lower. Deck, there's our starting note, and we can do this again. Nothing is better than tapping on our bodies to keep a steady beat. One, two, here we go. Deck the halls with boughs of holly, fa la 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 la, la 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 la. Tis the season to be jolly, fa la 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 la, la 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 la. Don we now our gay apparel, fa la 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 la. Trow the ancient Yuletide carol, fa la 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 la, la 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 la. And then we go to up on a housetop the reindeer paws, out jumps good old Santa Claus, down through the chimney with lots of toys, all for the little ones' Christmas joys. Ho, 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 ho,
who wouldn't go? Ho, 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 who wouldn't go? Up on the housetop, click, click, click. Down through the chimney with good Saint Nick. And then we have dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh. O'er the fields we go, laughing all the way. Bells on bobtail ring, making spirits bright. What fun it is to ride and sing a sleighing song tonight. Oh, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Woo-hoo! Everyone unmute for me, please. Wonderful. Okay. Everyone raise their hands high and tell me where you're going. You're really looking forward to singing this together with each other. And we'll just, yahoo!
Yahoo!
We are going to sing just the chorus of Jingle Bells together, and we'll sing it twice. It's going to be a mess, but we don't care. So sing it with as much gusto as you've got. Here we go. And again, I don't know if you're enjoying this, but I love patting my body with crossed hands. Great for the brain and helps with balance tremendously. One, two, here we go. Jingle bells, jingle, jingle, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in one horse open sleigh. Did you see my giant Santa Claus behind me?
Yes.
I love him, and he has jingle bells on him, and he lights up at night, and he kind of scares our little ones, but they're getting used to him. He's going to go in the sleigh. Okay, so let's see what's next. Oh, with the majority of you down in California, I thought White Christmas, it would be a great song to sing because I'm sure you're all dreaming of a white Christmas. Where I live, which you can see out here, I'm up in Seattle, or actually outside of Seattle, very close to Mount Rainier. We did have snow on the ground yesterday, and generally we will have snow for Christmas. I understand there's about 12 inches of snow just as you enter the Mount Rainier National Park. They've got so much snow, and that's just 30 miles from where I live. So we definitely can have a beautiful white Christmas. Mm-hmm. So I thought this would be a good one for us to have as our final song today. Maybe there's another one after it. I don't think so. It goes so fast. Okay, I am going to mute everyone out again. We'll make this beautiful. Okay. And you can still hear me okay? Alrighty. So the words are up on the screen and I will play it on my piano and with a little intro, I think. Okay, so we're with Ben Crosby. All right, here we go. I need to find it. Whoops. There's our first starting note. I'll get on the right notes. I'm dreaming of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know, where the treetops glisten. Listen to hear sleigh.
Guys were beautiful, just beautiful. I could hear you all singing with me. That was fabulous. So before I close this share screen, in front of you is a picture of the World Parkinson's Choir. And I am the music director of the World Parkinson's Congress or Coalition, depending on how we say it. And it's a wonderful organization that meets every 3 years in a different country. It is a medical conference that begins with the healing power of music and closes with the healing rhythm of the drums, which I think is fantastic. So usually at these congresses that they meet, there's at least 3,000 researchers, doctors, medical specialists meeting, talking to one another, sharing their research with one another on the way to find a cure for Parkinson's. It is the most uplifting 3 or 4 days that you can experience. And what they like best about it is there are people there with Parkinson's that can talk with the researchers, with the doctors, and share their personal stories, which is going to help researchers find our cure. And Rick, do we have time for me to play a little bit of the song that was played in Japan?
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, I'm going to, this song was played at the opening ceremonies in Japan in 2019 with a group. And the pictures that are up here, you can see on the far right, this gal was from Japan. The gal in the middle is from Indianapolis. And the gal beside her is from British Columbia. And I'm looking behind me, I see people from Australia, Malaysia. And the song was written by a young onset Parkinsonian that teaches at the University of Indiana. He's a musicologist. And so I will play a bit of that song for you. Hopefully it'll come up here pretty quick. So you're seeing what happened at the beginning of the Congress. It's quiet. And then the sound will start. Five countries. Isn't that fantastic? I am just so honored to be involved with this, the WPC. And again, here's a picture of our group here in Seattle. And I thank you so much for this time. I'm going to turn this off because we have one more step that we need to take before we close. We've got 5 minutes, but just so you can see a little bit about who I am, what I've studied, where I've been. Again, my website, just type in judyspencer.com. And my email is Judy for Tulips. Again, Judy with an I. And Tulips, if you're, Tulips is the flower of hope for Parkinson's. And so it also happens to be my favorite flower. And that's why I use tulips all the time. So let me stop sharing. And as I stop sharing, if you all could unmute. And if we can, let's put it on gallery view so we can see each other now.
Yeah, and you have to do that on your own.
That's true.
So we're generally in the upper right. There's a choice that'll let you have speaker view, gallery view, and that's an individual choice.
Good.
Okay,
so
now
if you want to be on gallery view, great. And thank you all. Thank you for this lovely day. And before we close, what I like to do is have a global share. And so my tremolos help me out here, Yvonne. It's a beautiful time of year. It's the time of year that we really give and share love with one another, no matter what our faiths are, and we care about one another. So think about something that you would like to share with one another and what you would like to share with the world. What might that be?
Music.
Music. All right. I love that. Mm-hmm. Thank you, Yvonne. What else? Engagement. I'm going to say friendship. What was that, right?
Engagement. Being engaged with others.
Very good. Okay. What else?
Understand people well.
Okay.
Understanding different people. Yeah.
Okay. Anything else?
Appreciation.
Okay. Appreciation. Love that.
Cure for
All right.
Parkinson's.
One more time.
Cure for Parkinson's.
Cure for Parkinson's, for sure. Mm-hmm. Okay. All righty. What I would ask you to do is put your left hand up to the screen as if we are holding each other's hands. And with our right hand, we are holding the gift of music, the gift of friendship, the gift of engagement, the gift of wanting and learning to understand one another and appreciation of one another, and the hope and desire and the future cure for Parkinson's. So on the count of three, we are going to share this with one another and with the world. One, two, three. Feels so good.
Mm-hmm.
So good. Thank you all.
Thank you.
So I just want to say before people go that two things. One, Judy, I noticed on your website on the World Parkinson Coalition site that on the second Wednesday of every month, you host a sing-along.
Thank you, Rick. We do. There's a beautiful global sing-along the second Wednesday of each month, and we have multiple countries that come together. We just had the one for December, and it was co-hosted with a fellow friend of mine that's in London. And the next one, we are actually skipping January, so the next one will be in February, and the co-host country is Ireland. And Jerome is a young onset Parkinsonian, very musical family, very entertaining. He has quite the sense of humor. So if you just go type in WPC or World Parkinson's, it will pop up and you can register for it. And if not, just send me an email and I will take care of it for you. We also have, I have the tremolo singers, and I have some tremolo singers on with us today, and we meet the first three Tuesdays of each month from 11 to 12. And if you go to my website, there is a registration page for that, and you will get notifications for that. I also lead monthly drumming, victory drumming, which is really fun, and it happens to be tomorrow at 11 o'clock. It's the third Wednesday of each month. And starting in January, we're going to be doing it two Wednesdays of each month. That is my background. My degrees were actually in percussion and voice. So I love playing the drums. And you can play anything. You can play the air if you want. A lot of people play the top of tables, or they get, as we did with children, find, you know, something, a box or a bowl that you can play on. You do not have to have a drum to join us. It's just all about the rhythm and the joy of being together and the joy of rhythm. So thank you for having the question, Rick.
Okay, you're welcome. I just want to remind people that we'll actually, this has been recorded and we will put this up on our YouTube channel within the next 48 hours. You'll get a notice if you're on our mailing list. And if you subscribe to our YouTube channel, you'll also get automatically noticed. Or you can go to our website where there will be a link as well. And that Judy's contact information and Tremolo's information will also be on that website in the YouTube description. If you have any questions, you can always email Judy if you have any questions about the Parkinson Network, about Diablo, or programs or speakers that you would like to see or you're interested in. Let us know. Write to president@pnmd.net or web@pnmd.net or programs@pnmd.net. We all talk to each other.
Lovely.
So I want to thank you very much, Judy. It's been a marvelous day of singing. And
I thoroughly enjoyed it too.
Me too. Thank you, Judy.
Yeah.
Happy holidays. Merry Christmas, everyone.
Thank you very much.
You also enjoy.
Inspirational.
Thank you, Ravi.
Yeah, you're welcome.